Hi, this is G.R. Sinha. In this lecture, we are going to talk about a case study of advanced driver assistance system, which we are calling here as ADAS, Advanced Driver Assistance System, and mechatronic system, that system which uses sensors and actuators. And as an example, we are going to discuss about self-driving cars, that is driverless cars, and the case study of driverless car we will discuss in this lecture briefly. So let us begin with, and we can see that there are two examples which have been displayed here. This is one of the driverless car which was tested by Nissan. And there is another driverless car, self-driving car, which was tested by Google. So we will be talking about these two driverless cars, self-driving cars, which were tested by two giant industries. So let us begin with lecture objectives. What are the objectives of this lecture? The very first objective is to know about ADAS. What is this ADAS? We'll try to understand. Then secondly, to have a case study of Google's self-driving car, which was tested by Google. Thirdly, to experience case study of Nissan's driverless car. So these are the three major learning objectives or lecture objectives which we are going to discuss, which we are going to achieve through this lecture. And for this lecture, my sincere thanks to these articles, presentations, and the resources that have helped me in preparing this case study. So the Advanced Driver Assistance System, ADAS, Advanced Driver Assistance System, a system which can help the driver, a system which can help drive the car with automated system, with good controlled and monitored system. So what this ADAS is? ADAS technologies include driver information system. It's actually a kind of driver information system, such as simple rear view cameras would be there, surround view displays will be there, and blind spot and lane departure warnings will be there. These are few of the examples, few of the features which will be there in any ADAS system. So the ADAS leaves the driver in full control at all times. ADAS, Advanced Driver Assistance System, it gives the driver that flexibility so that he can have good control at all times over the vehicle. Autonomous system, that is Advanced Driver Assistance System, is an autonomous system which includes automatic parking valet or impaired driver monitoring and override. So that parking valet and impaired driver, you know, the driver is deviated, distracted. So that kind of control and monitoring could also be provided by Advanced Driver Assistance System. The car can operate on its own. I mean, this is a concept. Advanced Driver Assistance System technology is a concept that includes driver assistance system, driver information system, and this technique, this concept, this system can be used in a car, and car can be developed as a self-driving car, as a driverless car that can operate on its own, with or without someone in the driver's seat. Driver may be there, driver may not be there. In both the cases, the car can operate safely. So the large production of automobiles with fully controlled is probably a decade away at this time. This is a bigger challenge in the automatic, I mean the driverless car system. If these cars are produced in large scale, that is fully automatic control self-driving cars, but it will take a lot of time. That is a major challenge. Though the essential technology for self-driving car already exists, I mean the technology is there. All sensors, actuators, all technologies, soft computing tools and technologies are available that could help in designing and developing that car which is driverless car, and it can be produced in large scale also, but it will certainly take some time. So to make it feasible, to make its viable implementation, to make its viable production, the technology needs to be commercialized, because the technology which enables the self-driving car is yet to be commercialized, and it has to be commercialized so that the large production could be possible, and it must be made smaller, lightweight and affordable. I mean the cost is another important issue in this particular technology domain. If the technology that can help the car to be used, to be produced in larger number of, you know, the cars and automobiles, so the cost has to be reduced down. The cost has to be reduced. Low cost cars need to be there, then only we can think of large scale usage and the implementation of the self-driving cars. Legal and social hurdles need to be overcome, which will take again some time. And this is another major challenge, because legal issues are there, insurance and the transport department have their own issues related to, because so far these cars have not been permitted, you know, on the, one cannot drive on roads. Then social stigma, social hurdles are there. If anything comes as a major change, big change, the change has to be accepted, but change is hardly accepted by the society. So that social hurdles is also associated with the self-driving car. How many people will accept it? How many people will have believe that no, that we can drive this, we can use this car successfully? Even the people will have apprehension. They would not, they would feel the scary experience sitting inside, you know, the car, and that is the social hurdle. So the information, automation, control and warning system. In fact, if we talk about ADAS, it includes information, automation, control and warning system. And this system has side and rear cameras. I mean, if you design automatic car, which is a driverless car, it must have side and rear cameras with a driver displays and warning of oncoming cross traffic, then ultrasound sensing of areas in front and behind the car obstructed from driver view. Ultrasound sensor plays here an important role. Traffic sign recognition, that is the traffic sign, traffic symbol must be recognized automatically, and the lane markings must also be detected by the car. There must be a mechanism which can detect lane markings on roads, which can recognize traffic signs and traffic symbols. Blind spot warning and night vision. This is another important aspect of driverless car. The ranging of objects ahead in conditions of poor visibility. If the visibility is poor, particularly when there is a smoke, when there is a fog, and the poor visibility is there, so the car must have capability to detect and range the objects in such conditions like poor visibility. Vehicle to vehicle and vehicle to infrastructure communication. There are other vehicles which are moving nearby. The vehicle is moving towards certain infrastructure, so that communication must be there in the driverless car. So what are the technical requirements for such system? The technical requirements, if we see this diagram very carefully, it tells each and everything about the technical requirement. It must have sensor to sense, and it must have some system to understand, that is to comprehend what has been sensed and what do we want to do. Then after understanding, it must be able to act. So for sensing, what are the components required? What are the technical requirements? Cameras and sensor processing. We understand in the sensor that sensor is a device, sensor is a system which reads some stimuli or physical quantity and it converts into some measurable outcome. So that must be processed by some signal processing so that it can be sent to further processing. Similarly, radar plus sensor processing, radar, then lidar, that is radio detection and ranging, then light detection and ranging. This system, radar and lidar, must be there. Then only we can think of detecting, then ranging the objects and controlling and having a monitored driving system in a car. So the sensor must include cameras. Sensor must include this radar and lidar, that is detection system using a radio wave and using the light. Then as far as understanding is concerned, that sensor fusion technique must combine all these information, all the information which are coming from the sensors, and this must be intelligent system. That is, sensor fusion must have some intelligence in it so that it can understand what the information is being captured, and accordingly this will act. What are different possible actions the system can take? It can not do anything, it can get some warning signal, it can get some assistance, and it can have control over brakes, control over steering, and control over other parts of the car. So this is the system in which lot of technical requirements are there, and mainly if we divide, these are the hardware requirement. Then there must be some technology which can understand the readings and the informations detected by the sensor, and according to this signal processing, the system must be able to act what it is desired, what it is required to act. This is a comparison of Ford, Daimler, Volkswagen, Toyota and Volvo. That is, these bigger companies have already their products which are not driverless, but in their system there is a system for integrated sensor. They're using technology, camera based lane detection, driver monitoring based system, car movement monitoring system. So these technologies are being used in existing automobiles, existing trucks and cars, and these concepts, these technologies could be used with some signal processing in driverless car. That's the idea. So we have a strength that the companies, manufacturing companies of the automobile, have already started using, have already got production of such vehicles where they are using sensor and integrated sensor and the technology that can help us in implementing, in getting, in realizing the dream of driverless car true, particularly on road. So let us discuss now, after discussing about ADAS, let us discuss about a case study of Google's driverless car. Google's driverless car, a prototype technology, was tested by the Google, where the driver seat is all laced with scanner, rotating sensor, video camera, data capture and analysis. This was the car which was tested. We can see in the diagram that there are many cameras, many sensors which are connected all around the car that can help us, that can help the car guide its ride. Then this is one example, that is a lidar based sensor detection system that can help. This is the car used by the Google, that is tested by the Google. This is another diagram where it can detect even the lane also. You can see that there is a lane clearly, and this particular object is not being, it's being properly detected, and the car is driving very smoothly and safely. What are the advantages and disadvantages? Safer environment and convenient. Safer environment, the car can drive very safely and conveniently. Fewer accidents, the number of accidents will reduce because there are many difficulties and challenges if the drivers are driving the car. There are many reasons, many factors. So that possibility will reduce if it is a computer based, if it is a technology based and self-driving car, then the number of accidents and accordingly number of deaths due to the accidents will also reduce. Follow traffic laws. Computer understands the rules. Technology understands the rules. So those traffic rules and traffic laws will be trained to the computer or the technology, and therefore it will observe, it will follow the traffic laws, traffic rules religiously, and therefore it will eliminate the dangerous driving and the consequences. So that is another major advantage. Of course, there are apprehensions that if driverless cars comes in the market, comes commercially, driving and riding on the road, there will be loss of jobs. So one has to think upon this particular factor, that how to deal with, how to engage those drivers who are driving the cars which are not driverless. And the technology relies on the up-to-date technology. The technologies need to be updated regularly, then only the car will have that compatibility to run under, to ride with the GPS and other system. And therefore, it has to have up-to-date technology. Then, of course, the cost will be always more. So that is another challenge. But, when it comes in the market, when it is produced in large numbers, large scales, then the cost will also go down. The project is currently being led by Sebastian Thrun, director of Stanford Artificial Intelligence Laboratory. He actually is leading this, and this the person who is the director of Stanford Artificial Intelligence AI Laboratory is 2005 DARPA Grand Challenge winner, which is not a simple task. Is a coveted award, he has been winner of this challenge, grand challenge, and he has also been co-inventor of Google Street View. So that idea was, the project is currently being led by this great person. What are the components of Google's driverless car? The components will include, it integrates Google Maps with various hardware sensors and artificial intelligence software. Google Map, everyone knows that, because Google Map will only guide to drive and to ride the car with some hardware sensors and then artificial intelligence. Google Maps provide the car with road information. Hardware sensors provide the car with real-time environmental conditions. Artificial intelligence provides car with real-time decisions. This is a Google Map, and this is another diagram where we can see that LIDAR is there, then position estimator sensor is there, then distance sensors are there, then video camera is there. So position estimation sensors will be there, then distance sensors will also be there. So these are the hardware, but artificial intelligence is a computer based system, is a computing system which is actually artificial intelligence. So that computer needs to be trained that what information is being detected by the sensors, accordingly it has to take the decision, and that decision will be done by the soft computing technology, soft computing technique called as artificial intelligence. Artificial intelligence is actually the computer's intelligence, because computer is trained to do so, and therefore it's artificial intelligence. So LIDAR and hardware. What is LIDAR? Light detection and ranging. Like radar is there, radio detection and ranging. So lidar will be used light detection and ranging, also as LADAR, also sometimes called as, is an optical remote sensing technology which measures the distance of a target by illuminating with light. Generally the light is from laser, because we know that laser is a very good example of light source. It can scan the distance of 60 meters, up to 60 meters the distance could be scanned. Video camera, it is associated with video camera, and that can detect upcoming traffic light. Distance sensors will be used, which allows the car to see far enough to detect nearby or upcoming cars or obstacles, because the automatic car, driverless car, is required to detect even nearby objects, nearby obstacles, nearby cars or upcoming cars has to be detected. Then position estimator, which has to determine vehicle's location and keeps track of its movements, where it is, where it has to go, which direction it has to go. All tracking has to be done with the help of position estimator. So what is AI? AI is artificial intelligence. Google Maps and the hardware sensor data are sent to the AI, which determines what is the role of artificial intelligence. We have to understand the role of artificial intelligence is it determines how fast to accelerate, whether the vehicle has to accelerate or whether has vehicle has to be deaccelerated, whether the speed has to be increased or the speed has to be decreased, when to slow down, when to stop, when to increase the speed. All these decisions will be made with the help of artificial intelligence. When to steer the wheel, when to steer, which direction the wheel has to be steered, steering has to be moved in which way, that has also to be decided by the technology, which is artificial intelligence. So this was the discussion about the Google's driverless car. Let us discuss, let us see one more driverless car which was tested by Nissan, is this vehicle, that is, you can see in the figure diagrams that this car was tested by the Nissan. It was installed in latest autonomous drive technology on its Infiniti Q50 model. The name was Infiniti Q50 model. It was tested in the capital of Tokyo, that is, Nissan is a Japan based company, where in the capital of Japan, Tokyo, this particular car was tested. The modified car was equipped with 12 sonars, 12 cameras. Sonars are acoustic based sensors, 12 cameras, 9 radar sensors, 6 laser scanners to enhance the accuracy of its solo journey. It can travel, it can ride alone, that is solo journey, without any difficulty. It must drive very safely in the convenient environment, and therefore it was equipped with 12 sonars, 12 cameras, 9 radar sensors, 6 laser scanners. The test drive saw the vehicle travel, it was tested for 12 miles, around 20 kilometers, without human interference. No human interference was there, and the journey ended where it started. After 20 kilometers having a round, it reached the same place from where it started. So this is a system. The general manager of this Nissan strategy group, his statement is, what we have tried to attain with this vehicle is human-like, comfortable driving, so no jerking, no sudden movements. That is their dream, and they have been successful in designing and devising this particular car, and they have tested it very successfully. If people don't feel comfortable in the vehicle, it will not be accepted. If you say that it's a driverless car, and suppose the comfort is not there, jerk is there, then people will never accept this car. Nissan hopes to roll out new technology in time for Tokyo Olympics in 2020. That they have thought of. Let us see what is going to happen. Very precise and accurate testing was done. ProPilot system was used as a semi-autonomous single-lane freeway autonomous driving technology. It is already fitted in several Nissan vehicles on the market, such as Serena minivan and X-Trail. I mean, this ProPilot system is already being used in many of their vehicles by the Nissan. So this is a system which is an autonomous system, is also suggested for the driverless car. The challenges are there, and that challenges would be overcome soon. Many discussions of the government, insurance companies should be involved, because insurance companies have their own rules and regulations. The government has, the transport department has its own rules and regulations. They do not have any separate rules and regulations for driverless cars. So that discussion needs to be engaged, and after that it has to be accepted. Need to have some consensus to show or prove this vehicle is safe. Otherwise people would not believe that driving this car is a safe. I mean, riding this car is a safe. No one will have that courage to ride in that driverless car. So that confidence has to be developed. That consensus has to be made among the common people, common public, so that it can be used by all the people. This is the bibliography which was used. This is the list of articles and presentations which were used in order to. I have already expressed my sincere and humble thanks to all these presentations and the resources with which I could try to discuss few case studies of ADAS. The idea was, we have studied sensors, actuators. So where these sensors and actuators are used? And this is the most emerging application area where the sensors, actuators, and the concept of mechatronics is used. So I believe that this case study, which includes two different tests, one by Google and second by Nissan, would encourage, would motivate the young students, young minds, to start some research, to start some implementation, to start some research activity, so that they also can contribute in such great initiatives. And that's all about case study. Hope we'll have some detailed discussion about other case studies of sensors and actuators like self-driving cars.